立法會.
The President. This Council resumes the second reading debate on the shipping legislation, electronic certificates and electronic logbooks amendment bill 2023. Mr. Yim Kong. President, I speak in support of the amendment bill. Now, recently I have consulted the sector, and the response has been positive. First, the use of e-logbooks and e-certs can greatly enhance the efficiency of maritime services. Now, keeping paper-based work logbooks is very strenuous. Now, with e-logbooks and e-certs, data can be input quickly, and there will be less mistakes. Previously, because of manual inputs of data, paper-based logbooks will inevitably come with mistakes. Now with e-logbooks, with the assistance of computer, we can minimize mistakes. And also we can prevent forgery. Now with e-logbooks, we can apply authentication measures and also trace the data. Now also, e-logbooks can minimize the space required for storage and reduce the cost of management. And it is also environmental friendly. Hong Kong has one of the busiest maritime ports in the world. Now with e-logbooks, we can reduce the use of paper significantly and reduce waste and protect the environment. Now, recently, the International Maritime Organization has been promoting the usage of e-logbooks. Guidelines have been published to set a global standard on the functions and security requirements of e-certs. Now, Denmark and Singapore, the relevant authorities have been accepting e-certs and e-logbooks. Now, in our country, the country is also a signatory to a pact to use e-logbooks. Now, it is a trend of the maritime sector to transit to digital. Now, by applying e-logbooks and e-certs, it will help us consolidate our position as an international maritime center. The amendment bill is constructive, and in terms of application and operability, the sector proposed 7 suggestions. The government must announce the guidelines on using e-certs and e-logbooks as soon as possible and specifying how stakeholders in the trade can apply to use e-logbooks and e-certs. The procedures must be set out. Maritime companies and conveyors must understand the procedures clearly. Now, we have to make reference to the guidelines issued by the International Maritime Organization published in 2016 on using e-certs. Now, we have to apply a unique tracking number to ensure the authenticity of the e-certs. Now, concerning Section 35 F, G, and H, the governments must notify the shipping companies of the update and also allow the companies to check the application progress online. Now, we have to make sure that the e-logbooks keep the track changes on the logs, and also we must retain the amendment footprints to the logbooks and make sure that it is made available for ship companies to check. And also we have to establish a standardized platform for storing logbooks. This will enhance the security and reliability of the data. Sixth, we have to require shipboard staff to record the voyage of the ship as well. And also, the government should formulate a standard module of e-logbooks to reduce that inconsistency. Now, the government should establish a common platform for e-search and e-logbooks. Now, the trade hopes that the government can consider the above suggestions in formulating the platform. Thank you. Mr. Frankie Yik. President, the Liberal Party supports the shipping legislation, electronic certificates, and electronic logbooks amendments Bill 2023, so as to promote the use of e-certs and e-logbooks, including the registration of shipboard staff to enhance the efficiency of the trade. Now, the Hong Kong's maritime industry has 100 years of history. Now, in 1970s, we have established a position as one of the largest ports in the world. Now, we are the fourth most important ship registration, place of ship registration behind Panama and Libya. Now, as at the 1st of January 2022, there are 2,261 shipping companies registered in Hong Kong with a throughput of some 130 million tons. Now, in 2020, there were only 1,095 ships registered in Hong Kong. It has increased by 15.5% to 1,265 ocean-going vessels in 2022. Now, our attraction is that our quality of management is internationally recognized. Now, the percentage of impounded ships because of non-compliances only accounts for 4.59%. Now, to attract more shipping companies to register in Hong Kong, we have to make sure that our requirements are aligned with international standards. Like other logistics trades, the shipping companies have to go through a lot of procedures, including application for licenses and registration. Every time manual input is required, it is very strenuous, and it also takes a lot of time to verify the application. Now, with the advancements in technology, 10 years ago, the Marine Department has established an e-platform to accept e-application. And also, the system has been updated from time to time to accept more applications from shipping companies. However, because of the limitation in law, the system can only be run, the platform only accepts paper-based applications. Now, we have moved into a digital era. E-certs is a trend. Now, in 2013, the IMO published guidelines for the use of e-certs. Now, as an international maritime center, we have to keep abreast with the developments. Now, besides paper-based certs, e-certs will also be accepted after the passage of the bill. Now, there will be a QR code printed on the certs in the future. Now, you only have to scan the QR code to check the relevant information of the ship, including the maintenance and examination record. Now, this will make the surveying and also examination of ships much easier for the government. Now, also, the e-logbook system will facilitate the storage input as well as checking of records. Now, paper-based certs and logbooks are deeply entrenched in the trade. Now, the government would allow both paper-based and electronic form of certs and logbooks in the transitional period. This will help the trade adapt to the transition. Now, the government should enhance publicity to the trade with the ultimate goal of making certs and logbooks completely electronic. Now, under the National 14-5-year plan, the central government gives support to Hong Kong in four traditional roles, including international maritime centers. The government must offer more facilitation measures to enhance our competitiveness. The Liberal Party hopes that the government can formulate more measures to support the development of the trade, including providing tax concessions to bulk purchases from overseas to attract them to establish a presence in Hong Kong and use us as a platform. This will further expand our maritime sector and create synergy. Now, in recent times, our container ports ranking internet has been on the decline, and there are even people who say that this is a declining trade. Now, the Liberal Party thinks that we have to proactively transition towards high-end and high-technology logistics trade, but we also have to maintain our position as in the conventional maritime business, because we have inherent strengths like geographical advantages and so on. Now, development of the conventional maritime sectors is not inconsistent with the transition to high-end maritime business. Now, we urge the government to enhance the establishment of a smart port and provide more tax facilitation measures to attract more maritime-related business to come to Hong Kong so as to consolidate our position. Now, again, I urge the government to consider seriously establishment of a statutory body with enforcement power like AA and the Maritime Board. Now, this is something that the industry has been calling for. The body will be responsible for establishing a development blueprint for the trade to ensure broader development of the industry. This will help us achieve the vision of an international maritime center for Hong Kong.
Does any other member wish to speak? If not, I now call upon the Secretary for Transport and Logistics to reply, then the debate will come to a close. Secretary. President, I move the resumption of second reading of the Shipping Legislation, Electronic Certificates and Electronic Logbooks Amendment Bill 2023, the bill for short. First of all, I'd like to thank members for their support of the bill and for the support of the resumption of second reading debate today. I'd like to thank Mr. Yim Kong and Mr. Frankie Yik for speaking. I thank them for their views and their support. The bill was introduced to let go on the 7th of June this year. It proposes technical amendments to 7 pieces of merchant shipping legislation to facilitate the use of electronic certificates, permits, licenses and logbooks by Hong Kong registered ships and seafarers to enhance marine service efficiency. With the advancement of digital technology, the use of e-certificates and e-logbooks in place of their paper-based counterparts gathers popularity worldwide. In addition to providing convenience to ship owners to apply for and receiving e-cert or licenses or permits, the electronic authentication system of e-certs also provides security against forgery. E-logbooks reduces the workload of shipboard staff in reproducing the data on paper and help ensure accuracy of entries. We need to move ahead with the times and adopt the use of electronic documents to further enhance marine services. To this end, the bill specifies that e-certificates and e-logbooks have the same legal effect as their paper-based counterparts, so the use of both formats meets statutory requirements. To further enhance the efficiency of marine services, the bill also proposes to add delegation provisions such that the Director for Marine may delegate power to public officers as appropriate, so certificates can be issued by the Director for Marine or delegated public officers more speedily to facilitate ships moving in and out of the ports. In addition, we will move a technical amendment on the text in Schedule 3 under Clause 17 to align the Chinese and the English versions. The amendment does not change the substance of the bill. I will move the amendment in the committee stage. Mr. Yim talks about the commencement date and the implementation timetable of the initiatives. If members support the bill will be gazetted next Friday and it will come into effect immediately. Hong Kong registered ocean-going vessels can use e-logbooks and e-certs. This will be conducive to operation of the Marine Department and ship classification society. The computer system is ready. When the bill comes into effect, the system will start operating. It can issue e-certs to shipping registers as well as a ship classification society. Ship classification society recognized by the Marine Department has many years of experience in relation to receiving e-certificates from other flagship places. So, well, the ship owners are also ready for the use of e-certs. By phases, the government has launched the use of e-certificates, licenses, and permits. We will first cover Hong Kong registered ships in the first phase, and in the second, we will extend it to local vessels. Some members are concerned about the work of issuance of e-certificate to local vessels. We have already started our preparation work that includes developing the electronic system and the software for issuance of e-certificates. We are also making preparations on legislative amendments. Our goal is to implement the measures next year. Mr. Frankie Yip mentioned about our status as an international shipping center. The government has adopted multiple measures to consolidate our status, to strengthen our capability to handle an increasing volume of throughput and to tie in with the needs of development in the sector. President, the bill proposes improvements on efficiency and convenience of ship registration. The bill enhances the services of the shipping registry, which in turn consolidates and elevates the status of Hong Kong as an international shipping centre. Moreover, the bill facilitates the launch of electronic services in the Marine Department. The legislative proposals under the bill is in line with the trend of digitalization in the marine and shipping sector and the government's policy objective to facilitate technology adoption and digital government transformation. The government has consulted the Hong Kong Fleet Operation Advisory Committee and Seafarers Advisory Board, both made up of stakeholders of the sector, on the proposals, and they support the bill. I move the second reading of the bill. I ask members to support the bill and the amendments. I so submit. Thank you. And I put the question to you that the Shipping Legislation, Electronic Certificates and Electronic Logbooks Amendment Bill 2023 be read the second time. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Those against, please raise their hands. I think the question is agreed by majority of members present. I declare the motion passed. Shipping Legislation, Electronic Certificates and Electronic Logbooks Amendment Bill 2023. This Council now becomes Committee of the Whole Council to consider the Shipping Legislation, Electronic